Hey, this is Daniel from Adorama Pro. Today on set, we talked about setting up a two-camera interview. We're working here with two Sony professional cameras, F5 and F55, but the techniques here we're using will work no matter which camera systems you use. You do want to always try to have two cameras that are kind of matching, so two Canon cameras, two Nikon cameras, two Panasonic cameras. It's going to make it a lot easier in the post to grade it out. Well, the way we're set up here is I have the typical two-camera interview. I'm looking right at the camera, like I normally am when I'm doing these, because I'm hosting. But if you're doing an interview, you typically don't want the person looking directly at the camera. My interviewer, Sal, is over here. So normally, he'll be asking me questions, and I'm talking in this direction. This looks much more natural, and it's a lot easier for somebody who's not professional talent to be looking at somebody having a conversation versus looking directly at a lens, which can be really uncomfortable for a lot of people. So when you're doing a two-camera interview, you've got two cameras, obviously. So you've got a close-up camera and you've got a wide camera. The wide camera is going to give you the sense of the environment. That's your main shot. So you want to utilize that well. Here, because I do these demos in our event space here, we shot here. You can see the space around me. If we were in somebody's house and they were a collector, let's say, you might have some of their things they collect near them or on the wall, or trophies if they're an athlete, things like that. You know, you want to fill this space so that you have you're telling the story there. The close-up camera is more for the reactions and to get the really nice shots of their face to really get the emotion of it. What you can do with the secondary camera besides just show facial expressions is you can show hands and details if they're showing something, if they've won a prize or they sew or whatever it is they're doing. You can show these emotions if they just happen to talk with their hands. You can show a lot of detail that way, and it gives it a little more help to the visual storytelling that. So the two cameras can be used, you know, to really give you a rounded image of the person. That's kind of B-roll in a sense with the second camera. I lit this in a really kind of conventional way, if you will, with a three-point light. I have over here, I've got my hair light. So this is a light panels Sola 4, which is a Fresnel style light. So it allowed me to really shape the light. I use the barn doors to compress it down. So I'm keeping the light off the front of my face. I'm giving myself a nice rim here. Over on this side of me, I have the brand new Astra from Light Panels, which is just an amazing new light, four times as bright as the previous one, bicolor, etc. It's just a really nice light. That's my main light on me. We can turn that off and we can see what that looks like, see what it's doing. So there you go. You can see I'm in the dark, basically, except for my little hair light going on over here. So if we turn that back on. So just to round it out, I have a fill light just kind of between the two cameras. I have a standard light panels 1x1, so we can turn that off. We can see what that's doing. So that's just bringing a little bit of fill, making the image, you know, making the shadows not so dark. This is especially useful if you're shooting with a DSLR, because they tend to be very contrasty. I'm shooting with a Sony F5, so it's not as big of a deal, but you want to have a fill light if you're shooting with a contrasty camera, or you're going to have, in your post, you want to, you know, crunch the blacks a little bit. So one thing that we did here to add separation besides the light, the light here just shining on me, is the store itself is lit primarily with tungsten with some fluorescent filled in. So I'm using daylight balance LEDs and I'm white balanced to them. So it made the store warm and I like that, but it wasn't really enough. So what I did do is I added to the daylight balance LEDs in the front, I added a full blue. So making the color temperature go up to about 7,700 Kelvin. We then white balanced against that so that the light on my face is very natural and even, but the store itself gets much more warm and inviting. So that just using that color separation can really give you a three-dimensional image to your interviews. So for this interview, in the way that I like to do interviews, I have two microphones set up. One is a Sennheiser lavalier, which I have actually plugged into the camera, recording audio directly. And then above my head, I have a Sennheiser shotgun mic. So I'm getting two sources of audio, and we're gonna mix them later in post. If you want some more information about microphones, you could check out our other on-set video with the microphone tests. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to Adorama TV, and I'll see you next time on set.